a great big San Francisco welcome to the Microsoft Professional Developers Conference, co-sponsored by Digital Equipment Corporation. We also want to welcome our guests viewing the PDC from movie theaters around the U.S. and Canada, watching live over CUCME, the M-Bone, and international satellites. To start today's session, let's welcome the Chairman and CEO of Microsoft Corporation, Bill Gates.
Well, good morning. It's super to be here and see the incredible enthusiasm that's built up around the internet and using that together with Windows. Today we have not only the group here in San Francisco, but an even larger group that's watching in theaters, over 50 theaters around the country. And I want to welcome them to the Professional Developers Conference. Well, now let's take that concept of a meeting lobby and consider, you know, how could that be used? You know, say you want to sit down and do a training session. Say you want to sit down and just socialize. Say you want to get together to discuss a product. Today, people use chat type interfaces, but they're not very visual. You have to type in all the commands. And there's no way, no reason it should have to be that way. And one of the companies that's been tackling this challenge of creating great meeting spaces is online. And I'd like to ask Henry Nash, who's the head of the company, to come up and show us some of the progress they've made in not only creating a visual way of letting people get together, but also now bringing audio into the experience in a fantastic way. And this is not just for entertainment. This can be used for lots of great business scenarios as well. Welcome, Henry.
Hello.
So what have we got here?
Okay, what we have here is a 3D multi-point audio VML browser. We're out browsing a space on the net, and as we look around the space, you know, it's like any other 3D space. We can move around. But the difference about this space is that there are other people there. So we're obviously embedded as an active document inside the Nashville shell, but there are actually people out there connected on the internet. So. To your point about socializing, let's see how we can interact with them. Hi there.
Hi, Bill. This is Dave from OnLive. Hey. And I'm here to help talk about the real-life multi-point audio today.
So you look good, Dave, but where's your body?
Well, one of the best things about cyberspace is you can decide to leave your body at home when you go online.
And
Would you like me to show you about some of the ways we can navigate through a 3D space?
Sure, sure.
Well, it's really quite easy. You can use your arrow keys and essentially use your left arrow key to pay left, your right arrow key to rotate right, or the up arrow or the down arrow to move forward and backwards. You can also go through some high-performance moves like... or you can spin.
That's pretty good. Can you show a motion?
Oh, sure. One of the best things that we have is the ability to show a wide range of motion and different avatars on screen. Let me show you what I would look like if I want to portray some angles, perhaps. So this is surprising.
Ah, pretty nice.
You know, I really like your avatar, Bill. Henry, why don't you take us into the customize your appearance and show how the range of avatar customization that you can have.
That's pretty embarrassing. I don't know who made that one.
Well, maybe we can improve this a little by hairstyle, maybe.
I don't know.
That's better, and maybe we can this up.
Looks like I've got lipstick on there.
Yeah. You can also, as well as changing your appearance, you can also morph your voice to be higher or lower like a robot. You can set up a profile for information you carry with you on the net. So let's go back into the space.
So now can we hear multiple people and talk to them all at once?
multiple and talk to them all at once. As well as one of the things that you just mentioned in the evidence customizing your appearance place, if you have a profile, you could use that to enter an email address so people can also send you email by, say, dropping a document on your head. But let's bring one of those other people in. I think in the space we've got Randy from OnLive also. Randy, are you here with us?
Hi, Bill. Hi, this is Randy.
Hey, Randy, how you doing? It's a little windy up here.
So show us some multiple talking.
Yeah, Randy, why don't you join me in a session of row your boat. I'll start out.
Row, 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 row,
We haven't quite gotten the singing online job for now. Maybe if we added a little bit of, let's see, how about some musical accompaniment? I think we've got somebody else online here. Are you with us, Mike?
Right. Yeah, I'm right here.
Oh, wow. We got a guitar. That's great. That's great, folks.
Yeah, so...
Well, why don't you tell us a bit about where you're connected, by the way, on the internet?
Oh, sure. That's great. I, Dave, am just backstage, and I'm connected locally. Randy, how are you connected?
I'm at the Online Technologies office in Cupertino, about an hour's drive from where you are, and I'm driving into a modem connection.
How about you, Mike?
I'm dialed in through my internet service provider, Devin Mateo.
One of the best parts about this online traveler technology is the way we've been able to meld technologies from Microsoft, like the Direct 3D rendering engine and Sweeper technologies that must be a well-integrated internet application, as well as the technology from online, which let us do the real-time multi-point audio over over low bandwidth connections. We can run on a machine that's got Windows 95 on a Pentium processor with just a 14-core Playstation 4. It's running today. We frequently have people dialed in from Korea or Sweden or other countries like Florida.
Okay, Dave, well, I know you're going to have more people come and join the party there in cyberspace. We'll take the volume down and just watch you play while we just have to talk a bit about what this means for the server side of the internet and so forth. Basically, what you're seeing here is an HTTP server storing a VRML file and an NT box that is running the voice server. So this is a way in which, using NT, we can turn information sites out on the internet into community sites. The online traveler, using these technologies, lets you go out and travel the internet, visit these communities, and interact with the people once you meet them, and talk to them, exchange email, and so forth. It's really turning the internet into a way of communicating rather than just information.
And so designing a new space, will there be tools so people can do that as well?
Yeah, one of the choices we made is, this is just a regular VRML space. You can use any VRML editor out there today. We had a couple of extensions to point it at the NT server that's providing the voice services, and then that VRML space can be looked at by regular VRML browsers or by the traveler, in which case it's a community of people interacting.
And so what kind of markets are you looking at here? I suppose even a company could have people get together and do various sessions this way.
Yeah, especially with the support for 14.4 and 28K modems. Salesmen on the road can dial in and do their conferencing, distance learning, entertainment we're seeing here, going online and meeting people. As you can see, there are avatars arriving as we are in the sort of party here. We've got a nice cat arriving. So there are a whole range of applications. I think you're right that it's not just about an individual technology. It's about fundamentally changing the way people communicate on the internet.
Oh, that's fantastic. Well, thanks so much for coming and showing it to us.
You're welcome.
Super.